Hello everyone, and welcome to another one of my videos. Before I start, I wanted to apologize for not uploading anything for a while. I was very busy with my school life and could just not find the time to record. There also were not many good updates on naval action that I could record. Now that that's cleared up, I'll be reviewing the new Santa Ana DLC ship, the second version, which is modeled after the actual Santa Ana. The older Santa Ana, also known as Christian 2.0, has now been renamed to San Pedro, which coincidentally is in this video. The Santa Ana is a Spanish ship of the line with 110 guns, 4 bow and 4 stern chaser guns. She is the most expensive DLC ship so far, even surpassing the DLC Victory at 63 euros. Santa Ana is the 5th first rate to be added to naval action. It currently has no color options other than the default paint scheme, which I'm using now. Santa Ana has 20,000 armored sides, 6,000 armored hull, and about 2,000 hit points on bow and stern armor, in her basic oak version with no port bonuses. All first rates have similar hit point status, so it's really hard to tell which one is the best in terms of tankiness. Santa Ana has almost no hull curve. She is just less flat than her bigger sister, the Santissima Trinidad, which is not really something to be proud of. Because of her flatness, she cannot bounce shots as effectively as the Laotian or the English Victory ships. But just like her sister Trinidad, she shines with her firepower. But unlike the Santissima, the Santa Ana does not have a large number of guns, but large caliber guns. The main deck can be equipped with 30-42 pounder long guns, which is standard for the first rate class. However, the middle deck is equipped with 32-32 pounder long guns, which is much better than any other first rate ship. The next deck is equipped with 28-12 pounder long guns, and the top deck can be equipped with 29 pounder long guns or 20-42 pounder carronades. The Santa Ana can carry only 1,000 crew, which is surprisingly little for her armament. If you want to fully crew both broadsides and the sailing crew, you will have to use British Gunnery Sergeant Sutkinet's Gunners and Gunner Encyclopedia book. Overall, I would rate Santa Ana 7 out of 10. She has the best cannon setup in terms of caliber in the game. She has the nicest standard paint job. Her armor is pretty much the same as the other first rates. If you could craft the Santa Ana, she would probably be my favorite ship. But since she's only a DLC ship, we cannot use rare woods to make her out of said woods, so we cannot bring the Santa Ana to her full potential. If the developers are watching this, please give us the option to make a DLC ship out of rare woods once a month, or even once every 3 months, or even better. Instead of letting us redeem the ship itself, give us the option to redeem a ship permit instead. I think most players would prefer the permit option over the ship option. The biggest drawback I can name is the enormous price, which I hope GameLab's developers will lower, but that seems unlikely. Anyway, thank you for watching and have a great day night. Let me know in the comments what you want me to play and record next. Now you can enjoy the gameplay of Santa Ana and San Pedro against Victory, Wassa and St. Powell.